Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So I have been wanting to do more of the precious metals refining. I've been kind of neglecting that series lately. And so I think we'll start back off with these gold-plated playing cards, which were sent to me by a fan. Let's see how much gold we can get off of them. So let's open this up and see how they look. Okay. So they are rather pretty. Oh, they're actually... base cards are in color. That's interesting. I almost don't want to destroy them. If it wasn't for the fact that it has this ugly print of a $100 bill on the back, I probably wouldn't destroy these. But I will anyway, because that's what they were sent to me for. Here's a little certificate of authenticity. Apparently they're covered in 99.9% pure 24 karat gold. Anyway, in order to dissolve the gold off these cards, I've decided that I'm going to use iodine. Haven't used this in a while. And so, let's make up an iodine leach. This will be rather similar to the bromine leach that I used in the last video I did in this series. But of course, iodine is one lower on the periodic table. Let's add some water. It's up to a rather... yeah, probably around half the beaker worth. You notice I didn't really measure out the iodine. I just kind of threw a few grams in there. If I need more, I can always add more iodine. Okay, so let's make the solution acidic. So it'll actually dissolve gold. This may not actually be necessary, but I find it makes things go a lot smoother. Now you'll find that the iodine does not dissolve, at least not very much. But I have a little trick to get to the iodine to dissolve. That is to add a little bit of sodium hydroxide in there. This will react with the iodine, forming sodium iodide. And for reasons which are too complicated to explain right now, adding a little bit of sodium iodide into the solution actually helps the iodine dissolve. There we go. Might need to get a stir rod to stir that up. Looks like it'll take a little while for the iodine to dissolve because it's in solid prills. But it shouldn't really matter too much. Okay, so let's take one of these cards and stick it in here and see if it'll actually work to dissolve the gold off of it. All right, I'm gonna leave it like that for a little while. I'm actually going to go run down to the store. I've got a time-lapse camera going, so see you guys in a bit. Okay, back from the store, and the plating on these card appears not to be touched even a little bit. Maybe a little. No, it's just iodine. That is mildly concerning. Yeah, it's not even less shiny. So there's a couple of things that could cause that. You know, maybe my solution wasn't concentrated enough. The iodine hadn't all dissolved. But if the gold's as thin as I think it is, that should have been enough to do it, given how long I had it in there. Okay, so I've mixed up some aqua regia, which is nitric acid mixed with hydrochloric acid. Let's put that there. That should have instantly reacted. Or just about instantly. Yeah, it's not reacting at all. In fact, it's beaten up a little bit. Okay, so the second possibility is maybe the gold is underneath of something. You know, maybe that's just to protect it. So let's get rid of this acid. Okay. Let's try some lacquer thinner. If there's like a plastic coating or something, this should just take it right off. Now let's try the acid again. Same thing. Yeah, it's not reacting at all. Interesting.
Yeah, let's go grab the x-ray. Let's see if this is even gold. All right, let's just x-ray this stack here. See what we wind up with. Okay. All right, so it's just giving me light elements there. Let's have a look at the graph. Well, I can tell you right now there's no gold in that. So there should be a spike right over here at 9.7. Yeah, that's just noise. There's no gold there. So, I went and got a piece of gold leaf that I know to be genuine. Let's set this right there. I'll probably just leave it in the paper, that's fine. Let's try this again. Okay. Yeah, I see. Now it's showing the heavy element there. Let's go into the, yep. See those two spikes? Those are our gold. So, the x-ray doesn't lie. These cards are not genuine. That is interesting. They even come with a certificate of authenticity. They're completely fake though. So I did a quick Google search for gold playing cards, and you can probably see that these are the first thing that shows up. Just look at this. So there's $20, $12, even though they look identical. $18 at Walmart. $80. Now I suspect that maybe the cheaper ones are knockoff and the more expensive ones are real. Maybe these are like a fake, like a copy of the more expensive ones. Because $80 seems more reasonable for something that's plated in gold. But $4 is, well, $5 is definitely probably not. They're actually quite common by the looks of it. How many times do these sell? They've got 369 reviews, so at least that many people have bought them. Let's actually look at some of these reviews. This is just sad. Well, anyway, now what I really want to know is actually what is this gold coloring that's on these cards? Because though I've determined it's a fake, it's a really good fake. It does look like gold. I think I had a little bit of a gold leaf on there and it looked the same. My guess is that it's probably anodized aluminum with some, you know, gold-colored ink soaked into it. I can test that with the x-ray. Aluminum is on the lighter end of the things that I can detect with that. In fact, it doesn't do it very well, but I should be able to confirm whether it has aluminum or not. I'm going to have to change modes on this, and it'll take a little longer for the test to happen. Okay, so this is telling me that it's got some phosphorus, sulfur, aluminum, and silicon. Keep in mind the lighter elements will not show up on this. If I zoom in here, let's see, what is that high peak? Okay, that's chlorine. Aluminum would be down closer to zero. So this peak right there is the aluminum. So it does have aluminum in it. This tells me that it, well, it doesn't rule out the anodized aluminum theory. Actually, you know what? While we're at it, let's try one more test to see if we can confirm the anodized aluminum. So a little bit of sodium hydroxide. A little bit of water to mix up a concentrated solution. I'm just going to tear off a corner of this. Let's see what this does to it. Well, the sodium hydroxide didn't appear to dissolve the coating. but it did make it come off. See that? It's clear plastic underneath. Yeah. I don't know what it is.
I'm actually quite impressed with how well it's faked. But it is a fake. Well, I got some more of the gold leaf out. Let's actually pour a little bit of this iodine solution off, and let's show it actually dissolving some gold. That's probably way more than I need. You can see the iodine solution's a lot darker now that it's had a little more time to dissolve in. Let me just kind of... Oh, I lost it. Just throw some of these pieces of gold leaf down in there. This stuff is very sticky. So the time-lapse camera actually messed up. It didn't record. And so let's try this again. I just stick that right down in there. Watch it dissolve. Okay, so now that the gold's dissolved, we just transfer the liquid over to this test tube so we can see it a little bit better. Just like so. Now I'm going to convert the iodine from its elemental state to the iodide state, which is both clear and unable to dissolve gold. So we should see gold precipitate as gold hydroxide. So I'm just going to make up a little solution here. So I'm going to add the sodium hydroxide solution now. And with any luck, you should see a little bit of a reaction happening. Let's mix it up. Just a little bit more. Alright, that's probably just about it. There it is. There's the gold precipitate. Now I'll leave it to the reader to figure out how to filter that off, collect the gold, and also recovering the iodine is pretty easy. You just reoxidize it, because essentially we have sodium iodide in solution here. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time.